Farmers are chronically busy. There's always more to be done. But what if you could take care of spraying without the need for a driver with an autonomous machine like the one behind me? Sort of like those vacuum cleaners everybody loves. Well, this is the robot-ready Pinto from Croplands, featuring the autonomous spot spraying Weed It system. Croplands offer these robots here in Australia right now with a range of self-driving tractor units you can run up front. I've never seen one of these in the wild, so I'm a little bit dubious, but we're going to put it to work for the afternoon and see how it goes. So what's the secret sauce of the robot-ready Pinto? It's the spot spraying system. Now, spot spraying technology is not exactly new, but it has come a long way. This system uses an array of sensors that feeds information to little nozzles that kill weeds and nothing else. It's pretty smart. Being a small unit, these are great for minimising soil compaction too, but the biggest benefit they offer, of course, is not needing a driver. Once a paddock is mapped, the little robot-ready Pinto, pulled today by a SwarmBot tractor, will run around taking care of spraying while you handle the important work, running your farm. So Lachlan, we're here with the robot-ready Pinto, fully autonomous sprayer. Must be a bit of a process getting it started, right?
Oh, not really, mate. Just press one button.
One button. Wonderful. And actually getting it moving?
Just a matter of pressing the button on your phone, and away you go.
So another single click and you're done.
Yep, beautiful. Absolutely.
How easy is that?
Yep.
There we go. If you're looking to maximise the benefits of autonomous equipment like this, you can run multiple units all at once to maximise efficiency for larger scale growing operations. The unit features a 24 metre fully hydraulic boom with 1-inch stainless steel plumbing and triple X nozzle bodies with full recirculation. It's got a 3,000 litre main tank, so it's a pretty serious little machine. Dual flow meters allow for broadcast spraying, while the Weed It Quadro technology takes care of precise spot spraying duties. Little SwarmBot robot running it up front has a ground clearance of about a meter, which is pretty impressive, and it only weighs 2.5 tons, so it's really good for soil compaction. A tank of diesel, we're told, will also last around 24 hours. Obviously, I can't jump in and operate the robot-ready Pinto, being that it's autonomous, so we're gonna have to review this one from the sidelines. Worth noting is that this paddock hasn't been properly mapped, but for the purpose of demonstrating what the robotic spray can do, I'm told it's smart enough to find its way around as is. It's pretty eerie watching this thing do what would usually take a driver and a far bigger setup. I could see this thing paying for itself pretty quickly if you're paying drivers, but ultimately it's about improving efficiency out on your farm. From where we're sitting though, it looks like the easiest way that you can take care of spot spraying without having to lift a finger. Sure, you've got to fill the tank and tell it where to go, but the hours saved will quickly stack up. Well, we've spent the afternoon watching the little robot-ready Pinto run around the paddock. It's easy to fill, it's easy to start, and it's impressed us. It's a pretty impressive machine, and if you're looking for efficiency gains on the farm and you're struggling to find drivers, I think that could be a solution. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe for more videos like that one. And tell me in the comments, would you run one of these on your farm?